But here I am. So I've had a full day already, and looks like we've got a full day ahead of us already today.
Yes.
Again. All right, we're on the record today concerning several tax hearings, most of which I believe are mentioned. We've got several set, as we normally do. Absolutely.
Right, 24 LLC.
Oh, okay, I see that.
That's
all right. So, the first one, Lewandowski's been settled, and you're
looking for Dave and I think the client can be allowed to bring Wiley laptop.
Okay, so the case is settled, and that agreement will be filed within 14 days.
Yeah, it's actually.
All right, and then Attorney Olson. You're on which one?
Brian.
Oh, Boyd Cobbins. Who do you have? June 3rd. Here, 9:30. On tax.
Yeah, okay.
No. No. Okay.
At the first at 9:30.
Okay. June 4th. Anything else?
Other matters, John, I guess I'm not sure how you want to proceed, is entering Richard and John Tennyson.
Okay.
They're here. I don't know whether we're going to head for a trial today. It was continued last time over our objection. They wanted time to talk to the lawyer. They're here now. I don't know what the status is. I thought maybe we could knock that out.
All right. Wintering LLC versus Richard and John Ensign. Attorney Schuster, you represent Wintering LLC?
I do, yes.
And you are? This is Richard. You're John. Okay. Richard?
Yes.
We're set for trial. Are you ready to proceed? Is that sufficient time? If I remember, is this the one that's a farm and there was some tractors and... It's 30 days sufficient? Attorney Schuster.
He was continued from the last hearing, so he get a lawyer. And I didn't mention it before at the last hearing, but I got a call from Attorney Mindell only 30 days prior to that. Because they had talked with the lawyer, they know what the score is, they know what the situation is. Attorney Mindell knew what the situation was. I think 60 days is excessive at this point.
So you don't have any objection to the you don't have any legal objections. Well, let's go ahead with the hearing. You want to put on evidence? Just for the record, we're proceeding with this trial regarding 45-13-05-276-405.200-008. Attorney Schuster appears for Winery LLC. John Henson is here, self-represented. Attorney Wiley is here with his representative from the Auditor's Office in Shite. Attorney Bratz, are you on this case?
He's a representative of the party. He's not here as a lawyer.
I've sent to the court what I've marked as petitioner's exhibit A, an exhibit that contains 14 sub-exhibits within it, the numbers 1 through 14. Exhibit 1, Your Honor, is the tax sale certificate issued upon this property and dated August 27, 2012, for the admission into evidence of sub-exhibit 1.
Well, Mr. Henson, have you had a chance to look at, has this been provided to him beforehand? Do you have any objection to any of these documents being admitted into evidence?
Well, I've got the
Other than that, any objection to the admission of the exhibits? Petitioner's exhibit A is admitted. Do you have any other evidence?
No.
Yes. Ms. Branson, do you have any evidence that you wish to put forth? All right. Court will take it under advisement. Tender a form order, you then send?
I believe so, Judge. We can file a petition for insurance and tax. I'll submit a paper for this case.
Okay. The court's going to take it under advisement. I can take it under advisement up to a period of 30 days. If I granted this at the end of the 30 days, you'd have 30 days. After that, they'll get an order, they'll go to the auditor's office. They may have a little bit more time before they get a deed, but I would operate under the assumption you'll have 30 days. It'll probably end up being 45 or more, but... I have to rule within 30 days. If I waited till 30 days, yes.
Okay.
They'll get something in the mail. But I will start out. Okay? All right, what's next? Center Bank, that's one case, isn't it? There's three.
Yeah.
Right.
All
right. Attorney Schuster represents Winning LLC, and Attorney Craig represents Center Bank. Or no? Right. Right. You ready to proceed?
Yes.
All right.
For a separation, but.
Any objection? Do you have any objection to any of the exhibits in the binder?
That's exhibits 1 through 31.
Yes. All right, exhibits 1 through 31 are admitted. Do you have any other evidence?
No, Your Honor.
Okay.
I guess there's somebody to make a motion under Federal Rule 41 that doesn't rise to the standard necessary to proceed forward.
Do you have that statute? Whether or not they did a title search or not, how does that play into whether or not the property owner received constitutionally adequate notice?
Well, it's not just that the property owner received constitutionally adequate notice, but the public whether or not Section 4.5 is defined. The only way for the court to determine whether or not this is defined is the people who should be serving do have a substantial
saying if there's a mortgage company out there and they don't notify them that you have standing to raise that issue. Excellent.
Well, I think that the case law supports that.
Section
1.6-1.1-25-6. And then outline the standard.
that statute refers only to the receipt of issuance of a tax deed. Something is already an issue. There is no tax deed issue. The burden there is not addressed what we're here for today.
So we should wait till you issue the deed and then come back? Is the theory that we're here now?
I'm just reading what the statute says, that a person may upon appeal receive title from date of the tax deed. We're not on appeal and there's no tax. So
sure,
you can't apply a tax.
Material compliance and pursuant to the case is required.
Sorry, what was the title search statute 24.5.7? What was that?
I think that's the sheet that we
need. Oh,
it's also.
Where is it in 4.5 that there's a requirement that there's a title search?
Not that there's a requirement that there's a title search. There's no evidence before you that would
be substantial property. Well, that's who they serve.
How do you know?
Well, even if there's a title search, I don't necessarily.
That would be the evidence that the court would consider.
That would go to weight. A title search can be wrong.
But
a title search isn't always right.
Correct, I agree with you. But
there's all sorts of kinds of evidence.
We would have the opportunity to attack the title work and say that it's inappropriate.
Well, you still do now.
There is nothing before you. There's been no testimony. And right. Before I do, Judge, I'd also suggest that the court review 6-1.1-24-1.9 that defines substantial property interest of public record. You don't have the information for you. They haven't provided it. The evidence is required to be, there's been no testimony, there's been no evidence presented. And what substantial interest of public record means, Title IV interest in effect possessed by a person recorded in the Congress or made available for public inspection in office of the court clerk. You don't have the information for the office of the court clerk. You don't have somebody testifying that there was a search done, and this is the information that we found. You don't have a title person that they can rely on and say, these are the things that we relied on, and then that can be rebutted. There is no way for me to rebut something that's not there.
Anything else? Well, they could move to reopen their case.
No. Yeah, if they close, the rest of the time, you
have to. No, see, there's the problem here is I'm the judge. You're not the judge. I can do whatever I want. Everybody knows that my policy here is to give everyone a full and fair opportunity to present any evidence they want. I've said that ad nauseum. So if they were to make that motion, I don't know if I'd grant it or not. You can certainly have an opportunity to respond. I don't.
Yes. We'll move to reopen.
Okay, response.
We object to that. There's no foundation in the law for doing so. Otherwise, it renders 41B almost moot because once we can point out the hole, they can open it back up. We can point out the hole, they can open it back up, and they can volley that into the right. They had their opportunity to present their case. They didn't. They provided us with their exhibits tonight. 2 days before, we relied on what those exhibits were going to be. Now, they're opening up their case with exhibits that were not provided as part of what they were going to do. And it is.
Okay, first of all, I'm going to rule on the motion. I'm going to say 41B motion. I'm going to deny it because I don't believe that they have to. The evidence before me is who they're claiming has a substantial property. If you disagree with that, you can always point that out to the court in the case in chief. Having said that, I'm also going to allow you to work in your case in chief and present any evidence that you choose to, subject to the rejection.
It's approved.
You want to present that? Well, there you go. marked, yes, is this marked in the book? In your book?
Cross-exam.